Welcome back to your weekly GIDDYUP. Today we have a lot to get through, so let's get started right away. So first off, we have our class elections. Final voting was this past Wednesday, and winners were announced Thursday. Here are the names of the people who won those class elections. Congratulations, we hope you have a great year next year.
Career fair also was this Wednesday. Hope everyone had a great job, maybe found a new job. I could use one of those right now.
Do you know what you want to do with your career, man?
No.
I know what I want to do.
Flip burgers?
No. Forever? Marketing? How about that?
Marketing? They use psychological ploys to get people to buy products. So if that's something you're okay with, I mean. This past Tuesday was the sophomore MYP personal showcase project. They had that in the gym. We have some nice footage that was taken during that time by KJ and Steph. We're rolling that right now. So last week, we asked you to send in your questions to our email about the student elections, and we got a few. One question asked, what are the responsibilities of being senior president? And Eddie, since you are senior president, I think you should...
Well, Trevor, the responsibilities of senior class president are fairly simple. So the big one at the start of the year that you want to start planning now if you're considering running for senior class president is senior sunrise. Big event, gets all the senior class together for that first week of school, very important. So moving on from there, all you're in charge of is basically organizing senior trips, talking with the boosters, organizing your senior sunset, and basically making sure your senior class is informed of all senior class events going on, such as graduation at the end of the year or payment info for their senior trip. So it's fairly simple, just want to make sure you stay on top of that.
Another question asks, is there a constitution to student government? And this is obviously probably like a push.
Trevor should answer that one.
Probably an A-push kid, huh? Probably asked this. Yeah. You should have done We the People if you're asking this question.
True.
Yeah, but to answer your question, no.
There is no constitution.
There's no written document, living constitution.
We have attempted to write one. It is very difficult.
We have?
Yes, we actually have.
Really?
During our student advisory board meetings, we have.
Nerd.
But it is very difficult as, you know, people always have different ideas, and it's just different. But maybe one day we'll have a Wooster constitutional convention. I could see it happening. All right. So thank you for asking your questions. This week, we have another question that we'd like for you to reply to.
That is, what do you want to see... at Wooster next year, anything you want to see at Wooster next year, any improvements, any suggestions for anything, answer this question at coltsgiddyup@gmail.com, and the email will be right here. Be sure to do that. This week, Bryson Parko hitting it out of the park with a nice sports report on our softball team. Check it out. Good job, softball.
The Warriors.
We're recording. Give it.
My bad, bro. Sorry.
But we're recording,
Thank you. I'm Bryce Parko, and here's your sports report. Today we got an interview with softball players Lisa Derry and Abigail Marines.
It's been pretty good.
I feel like it's been way better than last year, and that we've made a lot of improvements. So. It's a lot of fundamental work and more of just repetition.
Trying to understand the situations and get plays down.
People should join softball next year because the more people, the better.
Yeah. Fun time.
It really is.
Now we got some scores from the baseball and softball games this past week. Remember, if you want your highlights on the GIDDYUP, make sure to send it to #WHSports. That's been your sports report. Back to you, Eddie and Trevor.
Thank you, Bryson, for that. It's true what they say. You are getting better every week. All right.
Yeah, all right. So here's a club announcement on Switch Club.
Hey, guys. I'm Mia, and this is the club announcements. Today, we have Marcelino De Leon and Ronaldo Garcia from Switch Club. Today, they will be talking about their Super Smash Bros. Tournament. Let's take it over to them.
My name's Marcelino De Leon. I'm the president of the Switch Club.
And I'm Ronaldo Garcia, and I'm also the president of the Switch Club.
We play video games in the Career Center during lunch. We mainly play Super Smash Bros. We We are currently holding a Super Smash Bros. Tournament. We're going to hold one next year too. It's a $5 buy-in for a $50 grand prize. Sign-ups will be held during lunch. Come see me to sign up. If you don't want to participate in the tournament, you can always watch the tournament itself in the Career Center during lunch.
All right, this week's cult highlight is on JAG, Jobs for American Graduates, directed by Bianni and the cult highlight team. So let's get some of that.
More like Jobs for American Geniuses.
Jobs for America's graduates.
JAG is happiness.
Success.
Opportunity.
Creativity.
It's fun.
Family.
Home. JAG has helped me gain my confidence in building up a career.
Get a new job and make new resumes for future opportunities.
Let me stay in school.
Showed me what I want to do after high school.
Gain confidence when doing public speaking because I used to be very shy, but now it's made me a very outgoing person.
It really teaches you professionalism, both in the workplace and in real life.
The most valuable thing I've learned in JAG is that it opened new opportunities for me that I didn't know that were out here in the world.
Is that I need to graduate.
I guess that you can be successful no matter what. You don't necessarily have to go to a college to be successful. There's many jobs out there that don't require school.
It's definitely my 30-second pitch. I use that every time that I have an interview, and I find it extremely beneficial for me.
To keep moving forward and do what you actually want to do in life.
JAG to me is definitely a way for me to get experience within not only the career spectrum of life, but also with mental wellness and just life in general.
It's basically like a support system. JAG is important in high school because it helps you get your credits.
It gives you a sense of what you're going to get into going out of high school. So I think that's really beneficial for high school students.
It shows you about what you're going to do after high school. So if you don't know what you want to do, it basically helps you with that.
It gives you new opportunities for the future.
It helps students do well in school, and it helps them stay motivated if they have trouble with it.
My favorite part about JAG is it teaches you the life skills as well, but it also does it in a way that it doesn't feel like school, and it gives you the opportunities and you feel like you're part of a genuine family at Worcester.
It's my peers. They're very fun to work with, and they make the events even funner, and they're very active.
All right, next week we have our Worcester Theater presenting us with The Fox on the Fairway. Showtimes for Thursday, Friday, and Saturday are at night, and Sunday will be in the day. So buy your tickets. You can buy them in the box office or online at showtix4u.com. So make sure you support our Worcester players. Show them some love. These plays are always fantastic. So let's have a good time at that play next week.
So this past week, Eddie and I both saw Shazam. We didn't see it together.
No.
It sounds like we did, but we didn't.
No, I watched it first. So what are your thoughts on the movie? What are your thoughts?
I thought this movie was definitely better than like Justice League and Suicide Squad.
It's crazy, right?
When you leave a theater, you don't really
this is why I had notes.
You don't really expect much from the next one. I have my thoughts perfectly collected. He spent like 5 minutes writing notes for this.
Three.
That's five. Four and a half.
So personally, the things I liked about the movie were good actors. You know, it's hard to find good child actors. A lot of the times they can be
Darla.
Very difficult to, find.
Darla.
Darla was great. So I love these child actors, man. They were fantastic. Yeah. They played their roles perfectly, and they never made me feel like they were annoying little kids. They felt like they were their age, and they played it very well.
Yeah, there's just a lot of heart and personality. Mm-hmm.
Another thing that I really liked was the good character split between Shazam and Billy Batson, you know? The movie could have heavily focused on Shazam or Billy Batson, but it separated both their characters very equally, and you couldn't have had the story without one or the other. So,
and even, good job. Even in scenes where like he switches between Shazam and Billy Batson like a few times, you never get the impression that it's like two different actors playing the character. You feel like it's just one character, and it's really seamlessly. It flows.
It does. The only one thing that I kind of really didn't like was the third act was just a little too long. You know,
yeah.
The fight scene at the end was just a little too long, but I did enjoy it. I just wish they could have trimmed it down just a little bit. But it was very funny. There were a lot of jokes, which is another good point in the movie. Very humorous. I personally would give it a 4 out of 5 Shazams.
I give it 4.5 out of 5 horseshoes.
All right. I dig. It's a good roadblock right before Avengers Endgame to get you hyped.
Endgame, good. Good movie. Recommend it. Bring the whole family. That was all that we have for this week, Colts. Come back next week. New Giddy Up. May all your favorite bands stay together. We'll see you next week.
Dude, you just took every single line. Make sure you smash that like button.
There you go.
That was so sad.
Let's go get some ice cream, champ.
No.
Should they?
Ice cream is for winners.